Over the past 1 month, Beijing has been trying to use the COVID-19 pandemic for pushing its illegitimate expansionist interests in the South China Sea. And there has been a marked rise in its belligerence against other stakeholders like the Philippines, Vietnam, and Malaysia. But while the South China Sea is often in the news thanks to Beijing's belligerence and face-offs with other stakeholders, the Chinese Coast Guard has also been intruding into the disputed waters in East China Sea. Here, the Dragon has been challenging Japan, and there's a clear spike in the number of face-offs between Japan and China. The latest incident happened on Saturday when four Chinese Coast Guard vessels entered Japanese waters and started chasing Japanese boats. However, Japan would take none of this, and it warded off the Chinese with a warning. This happened close to the uninhabited Diaoyu Islands that were bought by the Japanese government from a private owner in 2012, but expansionist Beijing also claims them. The Chinese vessels entered the waters close to the Diaoyu Islands at around 4 p.m., and matters started to escalate 50 minutes later when two Chinese vessels started chasing a Japanese fishing boat in the Japanese waters contested by China. According to GG Press, a Japanese news agency, the Coast Guard's regional headquarters said that the Chinese vessels chased the Japanese fishing boat for about 12 kilometers southwest of Yuatsuri, one of the largest islands in the group. The Japanese Maritime Agency sent a patrol ship to the scene of Chinese belligerence and issued a radio warning, following which the Chinese Coast Guard ships left the area. Three crew members on board the fishing vessel escaped unhurt. In fact, the Chinese Coast Guard is looking to step up activity in the East China Sea along the contested waters with Japan. On Friday, the Chinese Coast Guard stated that its vessels had patrolled the territorial waters around the Diaoyu Islands. The uninhabited islands and reefs located in the East China Sea are rich in resources, a reason why Tokyo and Beijing shared decades-old territorial disputes in this maritime region. Beijing's expansionist ambitions in the East China Sea are about just as objectionable as its ambitions in the South China Sea, even though it is usually the latter which makes it to the news headlines. Ever since the pandemic took a grip on the world, the Dragon has been trying to tighten its grip on the disputed waters through sheer belligerence and intrusion into the exclusive economic zones and territorial waters of other countries, apart from trying to take administrative control of disputed geographical features. Last month, Chinese naval warships sailed through the Miyako Strait that lies between the Japanese islands of Miyako and Okinawa. Later, the Japanese Foreign Minister Toshimitsu Motegi had also lodged a protest against China for sending its naval assets into Japanese waters near the Senkaku Islands. China is trying hard to assert its sovereignty in the East China Sea by imposing an annual fishing ban in the maritime region, including in the waters off the coast of Japanese-controlled Diaoyu Islands. China is following similar tactics in both the South China Sea and East China Sea. In fact, it also imposed a similar fishing ban in the South China Sea, barring other stakeholders like Vietnam and the Philippines from fishing in the disputed waters claimed by Beijing. The unilateral fishing ban can leave other countries that are dependent on fisheries from the maritime region starving for food amidst the coronavirus pandemic, which has led to fishing groups in Vietnam and the Philippines to resist Beijing's unilateral ban. These countries are traditionally dependent on fishing as a means of survival, and a unilateral ban by Beijing is bound to slip them into a crippling food shortage. While the South China Sea has come under the spotlight of observers around the world due to a steep rise in Chinese belligerence, Beijing is also trying to flex its muscles in the East China Sea, making moves that are bound to provoke Japan time and again.